Hi everyone, this is Mix from Sneaks and Ball PH, and today we have a quick look and unboxing on the Nike LeBron 18 Melon Tint. To start things off, as I said in my review of the LeBron 18 Lakers, this melon tint colorway is by far the most popular colorway of the LeBron 18 so far. And this is primarily because this is the shoe that he used in Game 6, where the Lakers were able to clinch the championship. Not only did LeBron James use this colorway in Game 6, but he also wore it in Game 4 of the NBA Finals, where the Lakers beat the Miami Heat to go up 3-1. In Game 5, he switched to the LeBron 18 Lakers colorway and they wore the Black Mamba jerseys and everything. However, Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat were able to eke out a very narrow win to extend the series another game. Game 5 of the 2020 NBA Finals was pretty much nip and tuck, and you had Jimmy Butler going toe-to-toe with LeBron James, who actually finished with 40 points in that game. But in Game 6, there wasn't a shadow of a doubt that the Lakers were gonna win it because they pretty much pounced on the Miami Heat from the start and ended up blowing them out in the deciding Game 6. LeBron was his usual dominant self in closeout games by having 28 points, 14 rebounds, and 10 assists in Game 6. His magnificent performance in Game 6 pretty much solidified his case for Finals MVP. So when the Finals MVP trophy was presented, I think it came as no surprise that LeBron took his fourth ever NBA Finals Most Valuable Player award. He was able to lead his team to victory and averaged 30 points, 12 rebounds, and 9 assists per game in the NBA Finals, which is pretty amazing given that this was his 10th NBA Finals and his 17th season in the NBA. His fourth NBA championship and first ring with the Los Angeles Lakers will definitely be remembered forever, which is why I think a lot of people were very eager to grab this melon tint colorway. Then with that out of the way, let's get into the unboxing. So the box on the Nike LeBron 18 is just your standard Alpha Project inspired LeBron 18 box with that uniquely cut lid. Then opening these up, and here you have that pretty large lid. The paper inside the box is actually quite different because it shows like they seem like figures of women and plants, and I think this is because it's also called the Sisterhood colorway. Not really sure why, but the internet calls them the melon tints and that's pretty much what people go by. So that's what we will do as well. So just putting this to the side for a while. And then here you have your right shoe. And I think they got the color right because it does look like a melon, and it's just a very striking colorway and it's definitely a very unique shade. So here you have it guys, this is the Nike LeBron 18 Melon Tint. Starting off with the tech specs, I'll just quickly run this down because we've already talked about the tech specs with the LeBron 18 Lakers. So for the outsole, once again you have that split traction pattern with that waffle design here in the forefoot and that milk gray traction pattern here in the heel. The rubber does feel pretty similar with the LeBron 18 Lakers colorway, and the only difference that with the melon tints, it is translucent. I'm really hoping that the rubber compound here on the translucent outsole will perform just as well as the solid rubber, because from just playing with the Lakers colorway for a few games, it seemed like it was gripping the court really nice. Then moving on to the midsole, the cushion is exactly the same. So you have that Air Max 270 unit here in the heel, that full-length zoom unit that amazingly fits inside of the Air Max unit, and that full-length Kushlon foam. I have already used my Lakers colorway a couple of times and the cushion is just absolutely amazing. I've also used those outdoors and it's just wonderful for outdoor use. Because even if I played on concrete, that cushion really just saved my knees and really made it an enjoyable on-court experience. With the melon tints, it feels exactly the same, so I think it's safe to say that regardless of the colorway, the cushion on the LeBron 18s is simply one of the best. Then for the materials, once again, for most of the shoe, you have that Knitposite 2.0, and it does feel super comfortable on foot, whether you use it off-court or on-court. I have seen a couple people post about how the containment isn't on point with this upper, but for me, I didn't really notice it that much. But that could be just because of differing styles of play. I also haven't had any issues here on the toe because I don't necessarily toe drag that much, especially when I play on outdoor courts, which is where I primarily play nowadays because there's still a lot of restrictions here in the Philippines because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Then here at the back, you have that massive rubbery plastic heel counter and that soft neoprene sock liner. Then unfortunately, with the melon tints, it has the same exact tongue as the Lakers colorway, and it still just feels super thin and super cheap, and I feel like it's impossible important to remind everyone that you must wear higher socks when you're wearing the LeBron 18 because it's really gonna slice your lower leg if you don't. And even if I did have crew socks on, it was actually kind of chewing up my socks. But at least it was my socks and not my leg. I just really hope in upcoming colorways that they somehow change the material on the tongue. Because like I said previously, this tongue material is definitely unacceptable. Then for fit and sizing, this Melon Tint LeBron 18 fits just the same as the Lakers colorway. So the fit for most of the shoe is almost perfect, except you do have a little bit of space lengthwise. Aside from that little bit of space here at the front of the toe, there really isn't any dead space anywhere because the midfoot does feel pretty close to your foot. You're nice and locked in here in the heel. And the toe is nice and slim, so it actually sort of rests on your toes, giving you an almost one-to-one fit. So my recommendation would be that if you have a narrow foot, you can go down half a size or go through to size. Then for people with normal width feet, go through to size. And then for people with wide feet, I recommend going up half a size. Then for the aesthetic details, as you can see, it's pretty much all this melon orange. And here on the outsole, it has translucent rubber. You have that LeBron James crown logo here at the midfoot. And then here on the right shoe, you have the number 1. And on the left shoe, it says number 8 for the LeBron 18. Then moving on to the midsole, you have this clear plastic piece here on the lateral side of the midfoot. And here at the back, you have that clear Air Max 270 unit. For that rubbery plastic heel counter, it is semi-translucent. And you have your usual crown logo here at the back. And that Nike swoosh on the medial side of the heel. And then on those cutouts for the cushion that looks similar to the Zoom Generations, you have some script that reads from the city of Akron, Ohio here on the left shoe and established 1984 here on the right shoe. It says established 1984 because that is LeBron's birth year. So that's a pretty nice touch and I like how they put it on the foam that peeks out because it just seems like the perfect place to put it. Then here on the knitposit upper, it is primarily just melon tint. Plus you have a little Nike swoosh here on the toe. That really thin fused tongue is also melon orange. And you have those weird air bubble thingies on the tongue as well. The bottom bubble does have LeBron's signature, the middle one has air branding, and the top one has that LeBron James lion logo. Then lastly, here on the insole, it has this very interesting and unique design. And in the middle, you have a LeBron James crown logo. Then for the overall aesthetics, the silhouette on the LeBron 18 is actually becoming one of my favorite LeBron silhouettes of all time. I feel like it's definitely up there with the LeBron 1s or the LeBron Zoom Generations, the LeBron 6 and LeBron 7, the LeBron 11 and 12, and the LeBron 16. Of course, there's only been 3 or 4 colorways that have been released, but with more fire colorways just like these melon tints and the Lakers away ones, I think these could get bumped up to my top 5 or even top 3. This particular melon tint colorway is actually super pretty in hand and really cool looking on foot. It has this very distinct and unique melon orange color, which is definitely pretty loud. The cool thing about the shade of orange is that it isn't too bright, but at the same time, it is very striking. This melon tint colorway is definitely a fan favorite because it is very loud. Plus, this is the shoe that LeBron used when he and the Lakers clinched the 2020 NBA championship. I might be alone in this opinion, but even though these look super nice and they're hella fresh, I feel like I still love the Lakers colorway of the LeBron 18 a little bit more. So, you know, in terms of their overall aesthetic, I think that the Lakers colorway looks a little bit meaner. And if I were to grade the Lakers colorway in terms of aesthetics, I think it'll get a solid 10 over 10, while these would be right behind it with a solid 9.5 over 10. Of course, that is only my opinion, so please sound off in the comment section down below how you find the melon tint colorway of the LeBron 18. Are you like most people and have this as your favorite LeBron 18 colorway so far? Or are you like me and you love the LeBron 18 Lakers colorway a little bit more than these? Then for the price, the Nike LeBron 18 retails for 10,195 pesos here in the Philippines or $200. It definitely has a super premium price tag, but for what you're getting when you buy the shoe, I think it is pretty justified. Because for one, you have that super thick knitposit 2.0 upper, that insane cushion setup that includes that Air Max 270 unit here in the heel, a full-length Zoom unit, and full-length cushion foam. You have nice and reliable traction, and a killer aesthetic as well. When the LeBron 18s came out, I really hoped that Nike could have kept it to around the $180 to $190 range. But you know, they bumped it up to $200, so it is what it is. This melon tint colorway is actually almost sold out on the Nike Philippines website because the only sizes left are pretty small, such as like size 7.5, 8, or 8.5. So if you're like me and you wear a size 10 or maybe even bigger like a size 11, you're gonna have to go on the resale market to get these. That's exactly what my friend Nico Boramia did because this actually isn't my pair. Instead, he let me borrow these for review and it's it's actually one of the perks that we both really like sneakers and we both wear a size 10. So I guess in the end, that's what friends are for. He was able to get these from a reseller who charged him, I think, around 1,000 to 2,000 pesos more. And given that retailers sometimes really hike the price up a lot, that wasn't too bad. So once again, thank you and shout out to Nico for lending me his melon tint pair. And I will be trying to get these, especially if they drop on Titan for retail price. So there you have it, guys. That was my quick look and unboxing on the Nike LeBron 18 melon tint. If you like the video, please make sure to leave a thumbs up down below. Then if you have any comments, questions, or any suggestions for future videos, please feel free to leave them in the comment section down below as well. Then if you haven't already yet, please make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon for notifications. It would help us out a lot here at Sneaks and Ball PH.